I'm assuming that what we want,
all right.
But I thought she was having a seizure or something.
Because sometimes I've seen Joan here.
Right. No. I want them in that thing.
Yeah.
Don't you?
Yeah.
Okay. I want it in a notebook.
Then I don't have to worry. I was going to put mine in a notebook.
I've seen them fall over.
Yeah. That's right. So I'll take mine.
Okay. No, I think that's fine. Yes, we're working on it. We're trying to think about that. That's fine, absolutely fine. Whatever works for you.
Morning.
How are you?
I'm good.
But I think we'll get started. Welcome, everyone. It's so wonderful to see you here. Hey, let's have a big shout out. The end of the semester. I don't know who's the happiest, but I'm guessing it's going to be the students. So welcome, and please get yourself a last minute refreshment before we get started. And I think we're ready to roll. Well, let me formally welcome you to the College of Nursing. It's my honor. My name is Kai Moore. I'm the interim dean for the college. And this is one of the best days because we get to celebrate the awards of our students this morning, and then we get to see all of our students walk across the stage this afternoon. And what an exciting day for us. And for those of you who came to support your special student, I'm guessing this is a really exciting day for you as well. Thank you for being here, and let's thank our guests for coming. Just as a little bit of background for those of you who may not be that familiar with the college, we actually have 5 degree programs in the college. And we're going to be celebrating awards for students who are in 4 of those programs today. We have our Bachelor of Science in Nursing program that was actually the first program here at the U of A. It's a 4-semester upper division program, and it is an outstanding program. I'm sure the students will say how hard we've worked them, but for those of you who are parents or friends or significant others, our first-time pass rate for students who are in this program, and what that means is they sit for what we call NCLEX, it's their board exam, our first-time pass rate is between 95 and 96%. That is, like, amazing. And that's because we have outstanding faculty and super outstanding students. So, yay. Our next program is our Master of Science in Clinical Systems Leadership. This is an online program, and we actually have 2 pathways. We have a pathway for those students who have an associate's degree from an accredited community college, and we have a bachelor's pathway. And I want to say that this program has accelerated and has done so well. We have started this program about 6 years ago. We have over 600 graduates. So that's really amazing. And they're making differences in clinical systems across the country. It's also the first time that the students for this program are on campus. So if you're soon-to-be graduate of our RN to MSN in clinical systems leadership, would you please stand? I know there's a few. Well, let's clap for them in spirit. Because they will be here eventually. We also have a Doctor of Nursing Practice program, and this prepares students for the highest level of advanced practice in 6 different specialties. We have pediatric nurse practitioner, family nurse practitioner, acute gero adult nurse practitioner, psych mental health, and did I say family? And then we also have a nurse anesthesia program. We actually, I believe this afternoon, are graduating around 70 students, a little more than 70 students. This program has over 300 students, and they get put through their paces of clinical experiences, working with preceptors, and this is probably the largest graduating cohort that we have had from this program. I think that's right. So congratulations to all of you who are graduating from the DNP. And we also have our PhD program. This program is a little bit smaller. It prepares students who want to be nurse scientists, and that prepares them to do more research, understanding health problems of individuals, families, and communities. They're mentored carefully by our faculty. And we have 3 that are graduating today, and we're just thrilled for them as well. So congratulations to our PhD graduates. And our 5th program, which we don't celebrate today, is our Master's Entry to Professional Nursing. This is a program for candidates or applicants who have a degree in another field and want to re-career into nursing. We actually have students who come back who have up to doctoral degrees. We've had students who have law degrees, and they want to touch patients, and they want to understand about healthcare and be leaders in nursing. This is a 15-month program. It starts in May, and they go straight through to the next August. And when they're done, they feel like they have been really working hard. But they are highly sought after in clinical practice because they bring their previous experience, whatever that field may be. They're adult learners, and then they have this advanced degree in nursing. So while it is an entry to practice program, they have a master's. And for example, at Banner here, Kathy Townsend, who's the chief nursing officer, says, I want all of your graduates. So many of them, as well as our BSNs, have jobs before they actually walk across the stage for graduation. So it's my honor to be able to say we have outstanding students. And this morning, we're going to give special awards to those who have really hit the mark at the top. So again, this is a wonderful time for us. Award winners, we hope you stay connected with us and think about coming back because we always have another program we can challenge you with. And we love to do that. So it's now with great pride we'll want to recognize our student achievements. I would like to ask Dr. Lois Lusher, who's the director of our PhD program, to present the first awards. Welcome, Lois.
Thank you, Dr. Moore. The PhD program is small, but very mighty. And so I'll just present that caveat. The PhD program is designed to build brilliant futures with innovative researchers that can advance the science of nursing and healthcare. So we provide the science and knowledge that underlie the practices that, say, our DNP students engage in and study. So the culmination of their investigations is a dissertation. The Outstanding Dissertation Award is presented to a graduating candidate whose work holds high promise for overall impact on nursing science and practice. For our first award recipient, I would like to ask dissertation chair, Dr. Jane Carrington, to please come forward to present this award with Dr. Moore. Please come to the banner. The Outstanding PhD Dissertation Award for December 2018 goes to Catherine Dudding. Catherine, would you please come forward? Catherine's dissertation title is Recognition of Pain in the Neonate to Increase Effective Neonate to Nurse Communication. During her 17 years working in the neonatal intensive care unit, Catherine observed inconsistencies in how nurses assessed and treated neonates in pain. Catherine's dissertation research sought to learn nurses' perceptions of pain in the neonate and current methods of neonate nurse communication of pain. Catherine's dissertation research revealed two key discoveries. First, nurses perceive that neonates communicate pain in an individually. This differs from current thinking that neonates of similar gestational age communicate pain in the same way. That was one key finding. Second, nurses expressed reliance on monitors to help them detect pain in the neonate. So those are her two key discoveries. These are significant discoveries and significant contributions to nursing science. They lay the foundation for Ms. Dudding to continue this very important research towards sophisticated algorithms to individually detect and communicate pain in the neonate. These discoveries expand on current monitor designs to increase their effectiveness as a communication system. Catherine's dissertation exemplifies both excellent research and outstanding scholarship. Congratulations, Catherine. Our next presentation is the Mary Opal Wallanen Award for Outstanding PhD Candidate. Dr. Mary Opal Wallanen was an internationally recognized expert in geriatric nursing, a former faculty member, and a cherished mentor of many at the College of Nursing. Among her many contributions, Dr. Wallanen established awards for excellence at 9 university schools of nursing, including the University of Arizona. To recognize and outstanding thesis or dissertation with relevance to the underserved minority and vulnerable populations, including the elderly. I would like to ask Dr. Terry Badger to come forward as a PhD dissertation chair to help present our award. The December 2018 Mary Opal Wallanin Award goes to Sandra Curtin. Sandra, will you please come forward? Sandra's dissertation title is Mobile Health Technology Engagement and Communicative Health Literacy in Older Adult Cancer Survivors. Sandra developed a mobile app for myelodysplastic syndrome called MDS, patients with myelodysplastic syndrome and their caregivers, based on her previous work with the MDS Foundation. She tested her invention with older MDS patients. Her dissertation required not only understanding of her patient population, but also an understanding of informatics and technology. Her work is critical because the number of cancer survivors over the age of 65 will exceed 11 million within the next year. It's a huge population. Most of these survivors will require treatment, many over extended periods of time. With the shift to outpatient episodic cancer care, the increasing complexity of cancer treatment, and short provider-patient visits, the cancer survivor is expected to take an active role in managing their health. So Sandra's invention will help with all of these new trajectories in cancer care. Congratulations, Sandra. Right. Congratulations, Sandy. I would now like to ask my colleague, Dr. Renee Love, as the head of the Doctor of Nursing Practice Program, to please come forward and present our next award.
Oops. Good morning. Within the Doctor of Nursing Practice Program, faculty educate clinical scholars who will be leaders in healthcare as advanced practice RNs. Our nurse practitioner specialties include family nurse practitioner, adult gero, acute care nurse practitioners, psychiatric mental health nurse practitioners, pediatric nurse practitioners, and we also have a nurse anesthesia program. And beginning this fall, we'll have a DNP in informatics program. At the culmination of the DNP degree studies, students complete projects for improving clinical practice in healthcare systems. The outstanding DNP project is presented to a graduating DNP candidate who has completed an innovative project that forms a strong foundation on which to influence the future of clinical practice, as written in superior scholarly form. For our next award, I'd like to ask Dr. Terry Badger to come forward with Dr. Moore to present the award. The Outstanding DNP Project Award goes to Fungia Funguni. If you would please come forward. Fungia's project, Increasing Medication Adherence Using Motivational Interviewing in Patients with Depression, was an innovative project that demonstrated change in practice. She implemented the use of motivational interviewing in her PMHNP practice site and was able to demonstrate that this was cost-effective, efficient technique to improve adherence. And if you don't know, psych mental health patients oftentimes have problems with adherence. She was not only able to do that, but she offered other providers within the setting a motivational interviewing course. Thus, she changed practice at that site with the ultimate result in improving patient care. Fungia did an outstanding job. She is most deserving of this award. Congratulations, Fungia. I would now like to ask Dr. Jane Carrington, who is president of the Alumni Council, to please come forward to announce our next award. Dr. Carrington.
How y'all doing?
Bear down. Go, Cats, but you're so close. So, you know, you want to reward the effort, right? But we'll do it again. Bear down.
Go, Cats.
That's it. If only you knew how long I've been working with her.
Good morning. Now you know why I'm president of this council. I'm the most obnoxious person on the planet. As part of the priority mission of the Alumni Council is to provide support and recognition for college and nursing students, the council recognizes an outstanding graduate candidate based on the following criteria: promoting graduate spirit of fellowship among colleagues, exemplifying leadership and professional practice, demonstrating contribution to the college and or UA community, and providing community service through active participation in health-related activities. I am pleased to announce that this year's Alumni Council Award is presented to Catherine Dudding. A big day for Catherine. And she thinks she's graduating this afternoon. Catherine joined the Alumni Council with some coaching. As you can tell, I'm her chair, so she would say it was voluntold. Within a few meetings, her participation increased, and eventually she ran for secretary-treasurer and won the election. Her willingness to do what was needed, basically whatever I said, before and during homecoming made the event run smoothly. She took care of the tent on main campus and supported students and alumni who visited. And I have to say, homecoming last, we loaded up the tent with these big things. I heard a groan, I know. Dr. Love helped. I didn't think of a cart, and we were all carrying these heavy things, and Kathy got settled at the tent, and I just said, get rid of everything. I'm not carrying anything back. So through the rest of the day, the parade, I'm getting text messages, we're down 5 waters, 4, 3, 2, done. So if for that alone, she should get this award. Kathy exemplifies what it means to be a Wildcat for life. Speaking for the members of the Alumni Council, thank you, Kathy, for all you have done, and we will miss you on campus, but we expect to see you on Zoom to fulfill your term as Secretary Treasurer. Again, I'm always your chair. The next award goes to a graduating candidate from the Registered Nurse to Master of Science in Nursing Clinical Systems Leadership Program. To present, I invite my colleague, Dr. Cheryl Lacoste, Program Coordinator for the RNMS program, to please step forward. Dr. Lacoste.
Good morning. It is with great pride that the faculty are able to recognize registered nurse candidates who are advancing in the profession with their Master of Science of Nursing degree. The RN to Master of Science of Nursing Clinical Systems Leadership degree is an online program for our colleagues who already have an RN license and who want to apply new knowledge and skills to their career paths. The Academic Excellence in Clinical Systems Leadership Award is for an outstanding graduate candidate who has demonstrated transformational leadership skills, outstanding ability to contribute to projects as a positive team member, and excellent written and verbal communication skills in the online environment. The Academic Excellence in Clinical Systems Leadership Award goes to Carol Smith. Carol, will you please come forward? Carol is an experienced nurse in a neonatal intensive care unit who works as a resource coordinator. In this role, she supports nurses in providing safe, quality care and advocates for health and well-being of patients and families. She demonstrated strong leadership skills throughout the program as a team leader and a member in group projects. Faculty and student colleagues describe her as being kind, patient, intelligent, innovative, and motivated. In addition, she is described as having a growth mindset and uses feedback from faculty and classmates for personal growth and development. Carol is a true role model for excellence in clinical systems leadership. Congratulations, Carol. I would now like to invite my colleague, Dr. Melissa Goldsmith, coordinator of the Bachelor of Science in Nursing program and its Honors program, to come to the podium to recognize our next group of outstanding students. Melissa?
Good morning and welcome to our college. We will now recognize some of our outstanding students who are entering the profession with their Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree. The Gladys E. Sorensen Award for Academic Excellence was established by the College of Nursing in 1987 in appreciation of Dr. Sorensen's achievements and her development of the outstanding programs that promote the nursing profession. The award is presented to a graduating student who achieves excellence in scholarly endeavors, contributes to professional nursing through presentations, selects activities that demonstrate a commitment to nursing, and creates an atmosphere for positive communication. The December 2018 Bachelor of Science in Nursing Gladys E. Sorensen Award goes to Lauren Sparks. Lauren, please come forward. Lauren's academic and clinical performance were excellent. Lauren demonstrated advanced clinical thinking skills in the application of pathophysiology and medical surgical concepts into the care of critically ill patients. Lauren is a natural and effective leader, promoting fellowship, collaboration, and respect among peers. Congratulations, Lauren. The Mary F. Jeffries Achievement Award is given in memory of Lieutenant Colonel Mary F. Jeffries. Mary received her Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree from the University of Arizona in 1967 and a Master of Science degree in Nursing from the University of Colorado in 1975. She was pursuing her PhD at the time of her death in 1987 from leukemia. Mary set a high standard of professional excellence and was a strong inspirational advocate for advanced education. The award is presented to a graduating candidate committed to academic excellence and the pursuit of advanced graduate study. The December 2018 Mary F. Jeffries Award goes to Yasser Altahan. Yasser, will you please come forward? Yasser has excellent critical care thinking and is compassionate and caring. Yasser was initially a shy and unsure student. Hard to believe. As the semester progressed, he initiated interactions with his instructors, fellow students, and other licensed providers in order to improve his nursing and critical thinking skills. Yasser has gone above and beyond during his preceptorship and was even offered a position after graduation. Congratulations, Yasser. Yasser, believe it or not, actually taught childbirth classes with me last semester too, which was really fun. I'm sure he can say, you can say bear down. Can you say bear down? Bear down, yeah. He did a great job. Okay. In 1987, Dr. Claire Parsons, Dean of the College of Nursing at the time, established a College of Nursing Award for Clinical Excellence. In 1994, this award was renamed the Julia Hubley Award for Clinical Excellence. Mr. Frank Hubley proposed this award as tribute to his wife. Julia Hubley is a former graduate student and faculty member who taught undergraduates at the College of Nursing until 1983. She was recognized for her remarkable ability to communicate ideas, focus on clinical excellence, and share special teaching interest in leadership nursing. The Julia Hubley Award for Clinical Excellence is presented to a graduating candidate who demonstrates a commitment to professional nursing practice, selects clinical learning experiences that enhance professional development, collaborates with health professionals in the practice of professional nursing, and communicates effectively in promoting and giving care to individuals, families, and groups. The recipient of the December 2018 Julia Hubley Award for Clinical Excellence is Nicholas Krager. Nicholas, would you please come forward? Nicholas has the natural ability as a nurse with his compassion for patients and his excellent critical thinking. A comment from a manager where Nicholas completed his preceptorship stated, "This gentleman has the uniqueness of an experienced nurse with his knowledge, skills, caring of his colleagues, patients, and families. He will make a difference in the world of nursing. Congratulations, Nicholas." The Arizona Nurses Association Tucson Chapter 2 Professional Leadership Award is presented to a student that demonstrates leadership abilities, high-level skills in clinical practice, is an active participant in the Student Nurses Organization, has been identified by faculty as one who excels academically, and has demonstrated enthusiasm for academia and lifelong learning. The Arizona Nurses Association Chapter 2 Professional Leadership recipient is Emily Falk. Emily, will you please come forward? Emily's strong work commitment to community health and well-being extended past the classroom setting. Emily was a volunteer at Diamond Children's Center, organizing and leading activities, one of them being the Beads of Courage project. During this past summer, Emily volunteered with the Global Medical Brigades to assist at clinics in Ghana, seeing almost 1,000 patients a day in less than a week. Rotating between pharmacy, triage, education, consultation, and ophthalmology. Her experiences in and out of the classroom have prepared her well for her nursing career. Congratulations, Emily. Thousand patients a day, that makes me exhausted. Wow. The Student Nurses at the University of Arizona, or SNUA, is built on the foundation of making a difference in the BSN student nursing experience. SNUA is the collective voice of the BSN students, contributing to nursing education, advocating for students, providing community service, and supporting College of Nursing activities. Each semester, an individual is selected to receive the SNUA Award. The award is presented to someone who has contributed their time and energy in making a difference in the College of Nursing by advocating for student involvement and participation, and performing above and beyond the requirements of a nursing student. The December 2018 SNUA Award recipient is Aaron Tanzi. Aaron, will you please come forward? Erin has shown great leadership in organizing volunteer events as well as welcoming new students into SNUA and the College of Nursing. She has made everyone feel very at home and has proven to be a dedicated member to the club and is someone who really cares about the nursing profession. Congratulations, Erin. Well, I didn't have to walk today because I'm getting my exercise, being the MC here. When a group of five women met at the UA College of Nursing a few years ago, they recognized there are many qualities that turn a student into an excellent nurse, and not just academic success. These nurses have since graduated from our program and have developed a special award in the form of an engraved stethoscope.
The Stethoscope Award is presented to a student graduating with an entry degree that encompasses qualities such as problem solving, a passion for the field, excellent listening skills, and loving the hard work that nursing demands. The recipient of the December 2018 Stethoscope is Edward Palacios. Edward, will you please step forward? Eddie has always been generous with his time and so helpful with nursing events such as panels and interviews. Eddie volunteered to be on the peer mentoring team and was first to contribute materials for consideration in the College of Nursing Orientation Handbook. He has provided many great ideas during brainstorming sessions. As an officer in both SNU and Payne, he brought his past experience as a peer mentor into discussions which helped his fellow classmates, as well as staff in identifying areas to focus on training. Congratulations, Eddie. It is now my pleasure to acknowledge the College of Nursing Honors graduates and their advisors. Advisors, as I call your names, please come forward with your candidates to the photo banner with Dr. Moore. And I want to say something about the Honors Program. I'm the Honor Advisor, and on top of these students doing excellent in our BSN program, they have to maintain a 3.5 GPA or greater. And let me tell you, our BSN program is rigorous. They do an extra project that is just amazing, their honors thesis. So they are truly the gold medalists, I think, of our program, and we will be giving them a gold medal, basically, their honors medallion. So here we go. Okay. The first student I'd like to call to the podium is Julia Nye, and I would also like to call up Mary O'Connell, who was her co-chair. I was a co-chair as well, so Mary, come forward. And the title of Julia's thesis, honors thesis, was Best Practice Guidelines for the Promotion of Job Retention and Satisfaction for Nurses. So congratulations, Julia. And the next honor student is Daria Schaefer. So Daria, please come forward. And her co-chair is Dr. Sharon Hitchcock. So, and the title of Daria's honors thesis is Unrecognized Lost, How to Best Support Women Experiencing Miscarriage. Yes, we do. And the next student is Lauren Sparks. Lauren, please come forward. And I'd also like to invite her co-chair, Melanie Welch, to come forward as well. And the title of Lauren's honors thesis is Evidence-Based Recommendations for Skin-to-Skin Contact in Neonate Mother Dyads. Congratulations, Lauren. And last but not least, Mary White. Mary White, will you please come up to the podium? And Dr. Kaiser, are you here this morning? Dr. Lisa Kaiser was her co-chair. I was also her co-chair. And the title of Mary's honors thesis is Call the Midwife, Best Practices for Infant Safety During a Home Birth. Congratulations, Mary.
Thank you. It has been my privilege to recognize these wonderful students. And next, I would like to invite Dr. Mary Koithan to present our final group of honored students. Dr. Koithan.
Good morning, everyone. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to honor our BSN and DNP students who have completed the Arizona Nursing Inclusive Excellence Program. This is a HRSA-funded program that provides educational and leadership enrichment opportunities for selected BSN and doctoral students who participate in a variety of workshops, peer mentoring, tutoring, writing instruction, professional development, and intensive academic and professional development activities. These guys have been busy. Our BSN students are also required to complete 3 summer intensives. In other words, they don't get any time off during the summer, that involve coursework, clinical immersion activities, and peer mentoring. The BSN students, for instance, that we honor today, worked 40 hours this past summer for 8 weeks, and they participated in a variety of activities that included clinical and research skills, leadership skills development, writing excellence, testing acumen, and provider self-care. And guess what? They're not done. Because after they graduate today, they're going to be required to come right back to engage in a week-long NCLEX or the board's review and preparation course. Certainly, this is a group of students that very much deserve our recognition and honor for a job well done. Today, we are presenting our graduates with academic stoles, and you'll see us give them out. A graduation or an academic stole is a decorative vestment worn by their students with their caps and gowns. These stoles denote outstanding achievements in academics or membership in professional associations. This stole was designed specifically for our program and carries the nursing color of peach or apricot, as well as the University of Arizona A and our program name. So we invite you to please come forward when we call your name in recognition for your successful completion of our Annie or our Nursing Excellence Program. I'd like to invite Dr. Michelle Kanjan to come up to the podium to present our DNP graduates.
Good morning. We're so proud of our Pinnacle Scholars. So I'd like to recognize and acknowledge, first of all, Rita Gonzalez. If you're here, would you come on up? I don't see her here. We'll make sure she gets her stole. Next, I'd like to bring up Christina Gutierrez. And I do see her, so come on up, Christina. Next, I would like to invite Daniela Torres, who I understand wasn't able to join us today, so I just would like to acknowledge her. Great job to all of our Pinnacle Annie Scholars. Congrats. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Linda Perez to come on up to introduce our BSN graduates.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for being here. I would like to congratulations to all of these students, and I would like to first ask Mikael Altamirano to please step forward to accept your stole. Alana Mendoza, will you please come forward to accept your stole?
Kevin Olivares. I don't think he's here this morning, but we can clap for him. He did a great job. And last but not least, I would like to ask Sobia Ziri to come forward to accept your stole. Congratulations to all of our Annie graduating students. I would now like to ask Dr. Moore to return to the podium for closing remarks. Dr. Moore?
Thank you. So what'd you think about those students? Really awesome, right? Really awesome. And congratulations. Let's give one last round of applause for our honorees. And we get to celebrate them again this afternoon. I wanted to just give a shout out for some individuals here in the college who make things happen on an everyday basis. First of all those wonderful people in the Office of Student Support and Community Engagement, if you could stand up or move forward so we can acknowledge you and thank you. They're getting ready for graduation or convocation. I think our students would say when they have a problem, the first place they go is to the office right around the hall. And there's always a person there ready to help, listen to what they need, advocate for them, and make sure that at the end of the day, if there's a problem, it's solved. If there's something to celebrate, we celebrate it. So we're so grateful to the leadership of Mary Quithon and everyone in the Office of Student Support and Community Engagement. And then, of course, if it weren't for our outstanding faculty, we wouldn't be here today. So I would like faculty across all programs to stand so we can thank you and acknowledge you. Our faculty work really hard, and at the heart of it, they want student success. And you can see it in what we've done today. And lastly, thank all of you, our guests, our family, significant others, friends, for coming, for standing behind our students and graduates. And if you weren't here, they wouldn't be here. So will you please stand and let us thank you for coming. Families, yes, up, up, up. Well, this concludes our formal award ceremony. Please feel free to stay and get more pictures. We have backdrops, we have fun things, and we have more food. So enjoy your time here. And at 2:00, we'll see you on the big stage on main campus. And I hope you find that a really exciting event too. Congratulations again, and thank you for coming.